What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. This video is another ingredient breakdown video, and today we'll be talking about, by all means, the most popular molecular slash modernist ingredient, the one that you can find on the shelves even of your local stores, the one that there are thousands of recipes online asking for it. And even on this channel you will find quite a few video recipes with this ingredient. Today we'll be talking about agar agar. So if you are new here, let me tell you quickly how this video is going to be structured. It's going to be structured just as all my other ingredient breakdown videos. So first we're going to define our ingredient, in this case agar agar. Then we're going to talk about the properties of this ingredient and how these properties can influence foods in different cooking processes. And at the end, we'll talk about what all of you are here for, I think. We'll give some practical examples of the recipes that you can use this ingredient for. So first things first, what is agar agar? I feel like we don't really need to define it since it's so widespread, and I bet that most of you had tried it already in one form or another, so you would already know what it is, kind of. Agar agar is a gelling agent which comes from Asia. In fact, in Malay language it means gel or jelly. Just like many other modernist or molecular ingredients that we've talked about on this channel, like xanthan gum, like all the carrageenans and guar gum, agar agar is a hydrocolloid, which means that it needs to be mixed or hydrated in water or liquid in order to be fully activated and start forming a gel. However, it also needs to be brought up to a certain temperature in order to form a gel. And in this case, it starts from 90 or 95 degrees Fahrenheit. So you can't just mix it with a liquid and wait for it to form a gel. You need to also simmer it for at least 5 minutes. The cool thing about agar agar and the property of it that actually puts it aside from many other gelling agent options out there, and what you actually need to keep in mind when choosing a gelling agent for your cooking, is that it can tolerate quite warm temperatures. While its gelling temperature, as I've just said, starts from 90 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit, its melting temperature starts only from 185 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's quite a huge gap out there. So if you want to serve a dish warm, with some kind of gel present in it, like we did, for example, with our molecular borscht, where we actually used agar agar as the stabilizer for our foam, or as we did in our sweet and sour noodles that you can actually serve warm, I will highly suggest you to think about agar agar. As I've already mentioned, and you already know, agar agar forms a gel. But let's talk about the structure and texture of this gel. When you use it on its own, it forms quite a crumbly and rigid type of gel. And the best way to describe it is to think about hard-boiled egg white. This is pretty much how agar agar gel feels and is textured when used on its own. However, agar agar is a brilliant companion, and it works really, really well with many other modernist ingredients. And these partnerships can actually transform the properties of agar agar. So for example, if you use it with locust bean gum, the end gel can become more pliable and elastic. So you can use it, for example, as the coating or a glaze for your dishes. And if you use it with guar gum, you can form a more stronger type of gel, like we did it, for example, in our vegan marshmallow shorts. While as using agar agar in combination with glycerol or sorbitol, it can actually prevent the end gel from dehydration, which actually agar agar type of gel is very susceptible to. If you leave it uncovered for a while, it can dehydrate quite quickly. And that could be a great example for using this kind of combination in edible films. We haven't actually used it for our edible films, but I think it would be a great way to use it for our transparent ravioli and edible candy wrappers. We'll be right back. despite its wide versatility and the fact that you can use agar agar in so many cooking applications. You can use it as hot, cold, fluid, coating type of gel. You can use it even for spherification, like we did with our vegan caviar. You can use it for edible films, and you can even use it as a stabilizer for foams and emulsions. There are several downfalls of agar agar. The one downfall is that agar agar does not really tolerate high acidity. So if you really need to add very acidic ingredients to your gel, I would recommend to use it to add it after your gel had been fully hydrated. And another noticeable downfall of agar agar is that it's quite sensitive to freezing. It doesn't tolerate it. So if you freeze agar agar gel, the structure will be broken down and will start to leak out liquids in a while. And actually, many chefs use this to their advantage. They use agar agar gels as the clarification method for their consommé. And we also have a video about a perfect consommé using agar agar, but we haven't quite used the freezer. Instead, we use a different method, so if you're interested, do check it out. Okay, enough of the dry facts about agar agar. Of course, there are much more to know about this amazing ingredient. And I've already prepared a fact sheet with this information and more detailed information about this ingredient, as I did for many other ingredients that we covered on this channel. And it will be available as usual for my members and Patreons. Now, let's wrap up this video. So if you listen carefully, you would know that there are so many properties and so many cooking applications for agar agar. And I've already given you some practical examples during this video and even linked some of the video recipes that we already made with this ingredient so far. However, there is a limit to the amount of videos that you can link. So what I can do, I'm gonna write down in the description the whole list of the video recipes that we've made so far on this channel using agar agar. So make sure to check it out. And for now, guys, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like it as always and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. And I'll see you in the next video.